Today, we have Desktop Metal making a massive acquisition, the Czinger 3D printed car smashing lap records in Northern California, Icon printing the world's largest 3D printed building, and more right here on Vision Miner 3D Printed News. Starting off today with some investment news, we've got Desktop Metal acquiring ExOne. They're buying out all their issued and outstanding stocks for an estimated $575 million. Frankly, I would have thought it would be more. ExOne is a huge company. They've been around a long time. As you might recall, Desktop Metal has been basically acquiring everything left and right in 2021, from the DLP manufacturer EnvisionTEC to the powder manufacturer solutions company Aerosint, Adaptive 3D, and now one of the best metal 3D printing companies out there, ExOne. But wait, you haven't heard of ExOne? If you haven't, that's probably because they don't blow their budget on marketing. They've done a load of work over the last couple decades in binder jetting, focusing on industrial sandcasting and other metal printing technologies. The Metal Design Lab, in conjunction with Rapidia, is one of the most promising FDM-style offerings I've ever seen, even though it's still coming in around the $100,000 mark. So, the acquisition. Desktop Metal and ExOne have been understandably butting heads for several years now, since both companies offer industrial binder jetting and metal printing solutions. With this merger, both companies expect to combine their expertise, ExOne with the metals and ceramics, and Desktop Metal with their single pass production system. According to a press release from Desktop Metal, this acquisition will allow DM to cement its leadership in additive for mass production, something which both companies are really known for. The companies will be able to combine ExOne's direct sales force with Desktop Metal's global distribution network, which boasts over 200 channel partners, enabling them to push metal additive manufacturing more than ever before. Now, from what I've heard speaking with my insiders, the deal actually came as a surprise for most of the company. From what I know, they've really been competitors up until now. It'll be pretty interesting to see how the two cultures mix and what really comes over the next few years. Now, the merger is expected to be completed in the fourth quarter of 2021. So what do you think? Is Desktop Metal really headed to the top? Based on their past performance, with the ups and downs after going public earlier this year, do you think they're a good long-term hold or perhaps a good employment opportunity? Leave it in the comment section down below, and while you're at it, if you're liking our news series, subscribe. Okay, so let's change topics for a moment. Do you like fast cars? How about 3D printed cars? Wait, here's one better. How about fast 3D printed cars? Well, I've got one for you today. Just last month, the US automaker Czinger set the new production lap record around Laguna Seca with their 21C hypercar. Czinger was born out of Divergent 3D with the goal of demonstrating how 3D printing will revolutionize car manufacturing. What better way of showing that to the world than using a 3D printed car to beat lap times set by some of the most revered automakers in the world, from McLaren to Porsche to Lamborghini? The lap record was attempted and set on July 21st, 2021, with Joel Miller at the wheel using a set of road tires, specifically Michelin Pilot Sport Cup 2RA tires, not slicks. The Czinger 21C ran around the dry lagoon in 1:25.44, a full 2 seconds faster than the previous record holder, the McLaren Senna. The 21C is powered by a new 2.88-liter V8 that runs on a range of fuels like carbon recycled methanol and other e-fuels. It's also got two electric motors in the front, giving it a total of 1,250 horsepower. That's that magical 1-to-1 power to weight ratio, and all this results in a 0-to-60 time of 1.9 seconds, a quarter mile time of 8.1 seconds, and a theoretical top speed of 281 miles per hour. Yeah, it's pretty fast. Now, Kevin Czinger, the founder and CEO of Czinger Vehicles and also Divergent 3D, says, "As a blue-collar kid growing up in Cleveland, Ohio, I used to lie awake at night thinking about my racing hero, Jim Hall, his latest innovations, the technology-packed cars that his team built, and racing on the legendary Laguna Seca Raceway. The animating spirit remains the same, living the American dream at speed." I love it. Now, Czinger plans to produce 80 of these special race cars for the road, each one coming out of their Los Angeles factory. So if anybody at Czinger or Divergent 3D is watching this right now, we'd actually love to come up for a visit and make a video. We can be there in about an hour. We all know that everything in Texas is bigger, right? But this time they've gone all out with the world's largest 3D printed building. At 3,800 square feet, it's actually officially the largest 3D printed structure in North America. Designed in conjunction with the Texas Military Department, this new structure is located at the Camp Swift Training Center in Bastrop, Texas. They've created training barracks large enough to house 72 soldiers, and they'll start using it this fall. The training barracks were 3D printed using Icon's Vulcan construction technology and were designed by Logan Architecture, with structural engineering by Fort Structures. Icon keeps dipping its toes into military projects, as you might remember the vehicle hide structure they created for the Marine Corps last year. Now, this time around, they use their next-generation Vulcan printer and a special new construction material, furthering their goal of producing housing in a more sustainable and efficient manner. They expect them to last for decades, thanks to their robust concrete construction. Part of the reason the military has been so interested in Icon printers is their speed. They build quickly. It only takes a matter of days to erect an entire structure that would often take weeks or months with traditional methods. Now, this is particularly exciting for the battlefield. As they gain ground, structures can be built in record time with comparatively little effort. Evan Loomis, the co-founder of Icon, states that Icon continues our missional work to deliver dignified, resilient shelter for social housing, disaster relief housing, market-rate homes, and now homes for those serving our country. We're scaling this technology across Texas, the U.S., and eventually the world. This is really just the beginning of a paradigm shift in home building. Now, on top of all this, they've also got in with all the space agencies. They've been awarded a subcontract from NASA to deliver a 3D printed habitat known as the Mars Dune Alpha at NASA's Johnson Space Center. The 1,700 square foot structure will simulate a realistic Mars habitat to support long duration exploration class space missions. Chapia is a sequence of 3 1-year Mars surface missions simulations at the NASA Johnson Space Center in Houston, and they're using these structures to discover risk and resource trades to support crew health and performance for future missions to Mars. Future habitats have the potential to be 3D printed to eliminate the need for launching large quantities of building materials on multiple flights, which would be extremely cost prohibitive. This is the highest fidelity simulated habitat ever constructed by humans, said Jason Ballard, co-founder and CEO of Icon. Mars Dune Alpha is intended to serve a very specific purpose: to prepare humans to live on another planet. Construction scale 3D printing is an essential part of humanity's toolkit on Earth and to go to the Moon and Mars to stay. Now, the design of the structure is actually quite interesting. The layout has layers of privacy beginning from one end with a crew quarters on one side, and then workstations, medical areas, agriculture growing areas on the opposite side, and shared living spaces in between. They even changed the ceiling heights throughout the building, specifically to help crew members psychologically. As you walk around, the environment changes, giving a bit of spice to life on the foreign rock. And of course, they didn't forget the furniture, which I put money on being 3D printed as well. It's all movable, reorganizable, and they even have customizable lighting and built-in sound systems. Okay, this is sounding more and more like the condos you can buy in British Columbia from the last news episode. Think of it as the most luxurious living Mars has to offer. Except it's from the Earth. Anyway, I digress. They're focused on well-being, which is definitely a good thing. Icon also got more funding from NASA to launch Project Olympus, beginning research and development for construction on the moon. So, as they say, to the moon! Anyway, what was your favorite story today? Leave it in the comment section down below. And here at Vision Miner, we specialize in functional 3D printing, high temperature, high strength, industrial stuff, and 3D scanning, and all sorts of other stuff. But if you need that, hit us up on our website or give us a call. We use and sell all kinds of equipment that we use every day, from 3D printers to 3D scanners to all sorts of other things, so we can help you find the right thing for your job. If you guys like this content, if you got something out of it, you want more of it, let us know by hitting that like button and subscribe. Thanks for watching, have a positive rest of your day, and we'll see you on the next video.